Hi, I'm Dr. Jyothi Raghuram, consultant pediatrician at Columbia Shire Hospital's Whitefield. Most vaccines can be given even in the presence of a mild cold, cough or a diarrhea. There is really no contraindication. However, if a baby is running high grade temperature or has a more severe illness such as a lower respiratory infection, then it would be prudent to delay the vaccination for a few days till the baby is better. There is really no precaution that a parent needs to take before vaccination, except of course ensuring that the child is well. And after vaccination, as your doctor would have advised you, paracetamol may need to be used for a period of 48 hours every 6 hours to ensure that the fever is kept under control. Some vaccinations do cause fever in babies, particularly the DPT vaccine, and the fever is due to the P component or the pertuses component of it. This is expected, this is normal, and it usually subsides within 48 hours and there is nothing to worry. However, if your baby does have excessive crying, that is for more than 2 hours within 48 hours following the vaccination, or if your baby has persistent fever more than 103 degrees following DPT vaccine, then you should report it to your doctor. Most babies have mild fever, a little cranky behavior, which can be easily controlled with paracetamol for the first 48 hours following the vaccination. Other vaccines do not really cause high fever or pain, but mild fever may be seen with some other vaccines too, which can be controlled with paracetamol. Measles vaccine, MMR vaccine, varicella vaccines, that is the vaccine which is given to prevent your baby getting chickenpox, may also cause fever, but usually this is following a week or at least 4 to 10 days after the vaccination and not seen immediately after the vaccine. The fever is generally mild and can be easily controlled with paracetamol. Every baby needs to receive certain immunizations, most of which are completed in the first 2 years of life. You will find that your pediatrician will advise you about what immunizations need to be given to your baby. Some of these are essential to prevent the baby from getting diseases which may be life-threatening, such as diphtheria, pertuses or whooping cough, tetanus, measles, certain other conditions which may not be so life-threatening but which can cause morbidity, as in some amount of suffering, and sometimes the baby may even need hospitalization for the same, such as rota virus causing diarrhea, pneumococcus bacteria which can cause pneumonias, ear infections and infections anywhere in the body, hepatitis A virus which can cause jaundice due to affecting the liver, okay. So these vaccines are not mandatory, but they are recommended, and they are highly effective in preventing your baby from getting these illnesses. Vaccinations are mostly safe. They have very minimal side effects, such as some fever and pain, maybe for a day or two, which can be easily controlled with paracetamol. And the protection afforded by vaccines far exceeds these minimal side effects. So you will find that at birth in India, your baby will be given BCG vaccine, oral polio vaccine drops and hepatitis B vaccine, which is a mandatory vaccine. At 6 weeks, 10 weeks and 14 weeks approximately, the baby receives DPT vaccine, polio vaccine again, rotavirus, hepatitis B vaccine, rotavirus and pneumococcal vaccines, which will be again administered at 10 weeks of age, at 14 weeks of age. And then at 9 months of age, measles vaccine is given. At 15 months, measles, mumps, rubella vaccine is given. And 18 months is the booster dose for the vaccines which were given in the first 3 months of life. Most vaccinations are completed by 2 years. However, booster doses are given at 4 to 5 years of age, at 10 years and at 15 years of age. Ideal time for immunization is between 6 to 8 weeks. In India, we do start at 6 weeks, whereas in the Western countries, they start at 8 weeks. Hence, completion of 6 weeks would be the ideal time and not the beginning of the 6th week. Up to 8 weeks is okay to start off with the first dose of the DPT and the polio and hepatitis B vaccine.